Na Fury, wie wär's mit einem kleinen Ausritt? Hast du Lust?
To Mr. Jim for his birthday tomorrow.
I'll have the print back this afternoon.
What can we do, Mr. Jim?
Sorry to spoil your fun, boys. Kind of an emergency. Go up to the barn, get curry combs and brushes.
Yes, sir. Come on, Jim. This is an emergency.
How'd we ever let ourselves get stuck with the Springer ads? They ain't the kind of horses we usually put on the market.
I admit they're not up to our standards, Pete, but we gotta unload them at today's sale to pay back that loan at the bank.
Won't they give you more time?
Oh, I think I overextended myself when I bought that added pasture land last spring. Well, looks like sink or swim on today's sale. I'm afraid if we don't make it, I'll have to put the ranch up for sale.
Gosh, do you hear that?
Well, much obliged, boys. That's all for now. Oh, Joey, run down to the mailbox, will you, and pick up the mail, please?
Sure, Mr. Jim. All right, as far as the mailbox with you. Did you hear Mr. Jim said? We may have to sell the ranch.
That'd be awful. You mean we'd have to sell Fury, too?
Gee, I never thought of that. We'll have to figure some way to help Mr. Jim.
You try to think of something, and so will I.
Uh-oh, Jim, look who's here. Button your pocketbook. That old horse coper with his fat smile and thin pocketbook.
Howdy, Fulb.
Morning, Pigott.
Read about your sale, thought I'd drop in. When did you switch to goats? That is the crummiest collection of crow bait I've seen this whole summer.
You know, that's the trouble with advertising a horse sale.
Like turning over a rock. You never know what's gonna show up. But if we keep quiet, maybe he'll crawl away.
Oh, that's very funny, Jim. Very funny. But if these fugitives from a glue factory are any samples of this season's horse crop, I... Hey, now, there's a real horse.
Here's the mail, Mr. Jim.
Well, it's a fine-looking stallion, son.
Fine horse in the state.
Say, who is this bright young fella?
Our new foreman. Joey makes all our important beef.
Yeah, howdy, Joey. Pigott's the name. You know, it's a right nice-looking animal you got there. You know, he'd make a good circus horse.
He's still wild. Nobody can handle him but me.
He can be handled. What'll you take for him, Jim?
What do we take for him, Mr. Jim?
Mr. Pigott, there are some things in this world that just aren't for sale. And that horse is one of them. Joey, take care of Fury.
Yes, sir.
Well, I still say he'd make a good circus horse. I'll give you $100 for him without looking in his mouth.
Forget the stallion. The only thing for sale here this morning is that string of gentle trail horses.
Oh, so that's what they are. Gentle trail horses. Well.
You won't get them any cheaper by knocking them, Pigott. They're all good, sturdy mounts and well broken to mountain trail climbing.
This one looks like he's just climbed Mount Everest. Tell you what I'll do. I'll give you $20 apiece for them as they stand. That is, if they're still standing by the time the truck gets here.
You're wasting your time, Pigott, and mine.
I'll make it 25, but that's tops.
I'd rather turn them out on the range. So long, Pigott.
If you do, I'll get them for nothing. You know the law. Come across them grazing on public lands. Finders keepers. Just a friendly warning.
Sure, friendly like a rattlesnake.
On your way, Pigott.
Your price is too high, Jim. I can give you $40.
You better take it, Jim. 40's the best offer you're gonna get.
Gotta have 100 to make that bank loan.
Who's coming, Santa Claus?
It's a little early for him. But I am expecting a visit from that buyer for the Dude Ranches. He's in the market for a big string of saddle ponies. I just gotta do better than $40.
Well, what's it gonna be, Jim? Take it or leave it?
Well, I guess I'll have to leave it this time, Sam. Thanks for your offer anyway.
Okay. Let's get rolling.
Hi, Joy. Think of anything yet?
Nah, and things are getting worse. Nobody's bought any horses yet.
Say, maybe the bank would take the horses. I could ask my pop. He works in a bank.
Nah, banks don't want any horses. They only want money.
Say, I almost forgot. Take a look at this.
Swell, Ted. Make a slick present. We gotta find some place to hide it so Mr. Jim won't see it. Come on.
This is a good place to hide it. Nobody out here comes in here.
There's a good spot. Come on, give me a boost.
This, Joey. I never saw it before. I wonder if Jim will let me use it when we get Fury broke the saddle.
Sure he will.
Gosh, just look at those stirrups. You know, a saddle like this costs a heap of money.
It does.
Say, maybe we could sell it for money and help Mr. Jim.
Joey, my pop's been looking for one just like this to buy for my birthday next month.
Well, it ain't doing anybody any good sitting around here.
He said it'd go as high as $25.
$25 would really help Mr. Jim. It'd feed all of us for a month. But I can't sell without asking Jim first.
We'll ask him.
He's not here. He's out fixing a fence with Pete.
He'll be back soon.
Let me take the saddle right over and show it to Pop, and then bring it right back again. And if he says he'll buy it, then you can tell Mr. Jim and he'll be real happy about it.
Well, okay. But you gotta promise to bring it back before Jim gets home.
Sure, I promise.
We're all ready for inspection. Here, put this on. Bet it doesn't show any dirt at all.
Next thing you know, Joy will be putting ribbons in his tail.
Not even a dust mark. 100% perfect. And I'm not even going to ask you about the other chores, the tack room and so forth, because I know they're already done. You're a good hand, Joey. There are times I wouldn't know what to do without you. Now, come on, I got something to show you. Where's that saddle?
Can't figure. It was there the last time I come in here.
Joey, you know anything about it?
Yes, sir. Ted and I, we was looking at it and...
Well, go on.
Ted took it home for his father to look at.
What for?
He thought his father might like to buy it for him.
Well, who gave you the right to sell anything belonging to this ranch?
But I was only thinking about selling.
But that's just the point, Joey. You have no right to even think about selling something that doesn't belong to you.
But, Mr. Jim...
That saddle is not for sale. Now, you get right over to Ted's and bring it back here. And don't ever let that happen again.
Golly, Pete. I wasn't going to sell the saddle without asking Jim first.
Nah, don't take it to heart, Joey. Jim was just upset because, well, he sets a lot of store for that saddle. You see, the little fella that saddle belonged to was Jim's own boy.
No wonder he bawled me out.
Jim's got a lot on his mind right now.
Yeah, I know. That bank business. That's what I was going to sell the saddle for. To give Jim the money. Ted thought his father might pay as high as $25.
Had an idea or something like that. Now, look, Joey. Jim don't need $25. He needs a powerful lot more than that. But you stop worrying your head about grown-ups' troubles and hustle that saddle back here.
Okay, Pete. More than $25. Look, he gave me the money. The deal's off. Boy, did I get balled out. Come on, we gotta put the saddle back.
But gosh, maybe if you showed Mr. Jim the money.
Wouldn't do any good. He won't sell. Besides, $25 isn't enough. Mr. Jim's awful deep in the hole, Ted says. He might owe as much as $100.
Golly.
How does anybody make that kind of money?
Say, Pop knows all about money. We can talk to him on the way to the circus.
Circus? What circus?
Over at Plainfield next Saturday. Pop's taking me and he said I could invite you.
Circus? Of course. Fury and me could work in a circus.
How do you mean?
Fury could do his tricks. He likes to play circus. And this time we get paid for it. Big money, too, I bet you.
Gee, that's a swell idea. But how do you get hired by a circus?
You just go find somebody, I guess. Make them look at your tricks.
But we don't even know where the circus is today.
Mr. Pigott would know.
You mean the horse trader?
Yeah, he was at our place this morning. Say, he even said Fury'd make a good circus horse. He wanted to buy him.
You can't sell Fury.
Of course not. But Mr. Pigott would know how to get us hired. Come on, let's go find him.
Where?
Maybe he's over at the Barbie Ranch. There's a horse sale there today.
That isn't far. Let's go.
Hey, Dennis, Mr. Pigott! Mr. Pigott! Mr. Pigott, it's me, Joey! Mr. Pigott!
Well, 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 if it isn't the young foreman of the Broken Wheel Ranch and his man killer.
Hello, Mr. Pigott. This is my friend Ted. We're going to the Barbie to find you.
Well, good to see you again, Jimmy.
My name's Joey. We're kind of in a hurry to find you, Mr. Pigott.
I'll bet it's got something to do with that horse.
That's right. The smartest horse in the world. Do you think you can get us in the circus, Mr. Pigott?
Well, now, maybe. That all depends.
We gotta make a lot of money real fast, Mr. Pigott. Do you think you can get the circus to hire me and Fury do our tricks?
Well, no, I just can't walk up to my circus friends and say, here's the smartest horse in the world without some proof of it.
Oh, Fury will show you. Go on, Fury.
No, not right here on the highway. Look, you see that big pasture over there?
Yeah.
There's plenty of room for him to do his tricks.
Okay. Come on, Ted.
Thank you. better arena for an equestrian act you just couldn't find. Can you work him running free without a halter?
Put your head down. Hurry up! Hurry up! Say yes. Say no.
Splendid, my boy.
Give me a push. Now make him do something hard, Joey. All right. Toss you out of here, Mr. Pigott. All right, pick it up. Attaboy. See? I told you he's the smartest horse in the world.
Well, I never saw anything like it.
Mr. Pigott's gonna get us in the circus. Go on, give it to him. Boy. Stop it, Fury. Come back here. Fury. Stop it. Come here.
I agree, my boy. He is a well-trained horse. Now, all that's left is to get him into the trailer, and then we'll be off to the circus.
In the trailer?
That's right.
Can't I ride him?
Oh, no. Marysville's too far. It's 60 miles. Fury will have to ride. Now, come on. Let's see if you can get him into the trailer.
How much do you think the circus will pay us?
Some horse acts I know get $1,000 a week.
Gosh, $1,000? Do you hear that, Fury? Come on, get in the trailer.
That's the boy.
Sorry you can't go with me, Ted. Go home and tell Mr. Jim so he won't worry.
Sorry to disappoint you, son, but you're riding double with your friend.
What do you mean?
That's what I said. You're going back to your ranch and Fury's going with me.
You can't, you...
Tell Jim Newton I found Fury running free on government land.
Go home as fast as you can and tell Mr. Jim.
Back with that saddle an hour ago.
Saddle's inside. Ted brought it back. I saw him lugging it in. Two of them rode off someplace. He was kind of rough on the boy, wasn't you, Jim?
No, I didn't mean to be, Pete. But I can't have Joey selling things that don't belong to him.
I can tell you something about that. He wasn't selling that saddle for himself. He thought that getting $25 for it would square you with the bank. Just a minute. Let me show you something. Shouldn't be doing this. I feel like it's kind of called for now. Take a look at that.
Happy birthday from Fury and me. Your loving boy, Joey.
Don't seem like a boy who could write that was on the wrong track, does it, Jim?
Joey?
He's in trouble, Mr. Jim. That man Pigott stole Fury and drove off with Joey hanging on to the back of the trailer.
Pete, get the sheriff.
Yeah.
All right, now, Ted, get your breath. Tell me what happened.
We gotta get out of here, Fury. Maybe you can knock down the tailgate. Come on, Pigott, try to kick it. Better boy. Hit a little harder. Come on!
I covered the whole road from where it meets the main highway. Didn't see a sign of them.
Well, they must have left the main road to try a mountain cutoff.
The only one he could get through on, you just passed.
We'll ride with you.
Good deal. If he gets across the county line, I'm sunk.
Charges of false arrest, Jim Newton. That horse is mine. I caught him on government land, like I warned you.
Well, now, Pigott, that law holds only when the rightful owner isn't around to claim the animal.
Well, I didn't see you around there.
I'm not the owner. That horse belongs to Joey. And you took him against Joey's protest. Si?
Wait a minute, Sheriff. Can't you let him off this time? Please?
You heard the young horse owner, Sheriff. He refuses to press charges. Thank you, young man. Now we'll get my rig turned around, and I'll drive you and Fury safely back to the ranch. He's much too fine an animal to be allowed to go that far on foot.
Well, Mr. Jim, I guess that ends my circus idea about helping out an emergency.
Oh, it's a swell idea, Joey, but the emergency's over. We sold those horses to a dude ranch buyer.
And with you and Fury around, that circus enough.
Let me set the stirrup. All right. How's that feel?
Swell. You like it, Fury? Better than bareback. We both like it, Mr. Jim. You mean I can use the saddle right along?
You can do anything you want with it, Joey. It's yours now, for keeps.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Jim.